My entire family is prone to heart disease. My father, my grandfather, my uncle all passed away from heart disease in their 50s. I was bound and determined that that wasn't going to happen to me. And so all my life I have exercised and worked out. Scuba diving really became my hobby when I retired, and I really enjoyed it. I noticed when I was at Palau, which is a beautiful place, and I was diving, that I was using my air up in about 25 minutes when I can usually go for an hour. And I was also having trouble carrying my equipment back to the room. I was getting very tired.
When he got off the plane, he was bloated. He was sweating. His breathing was labored. And I recognized the symptoms of heart failure.
It turns out that my arteries, especially in the nooks and crannies of the arteries, were blocked pretty much. They didn't want to do stents because they were in dangerous locations and they didn't want to take that risk. So the alternative was open heart surgery. I went into cardio rehab at a place called Fit at the River, and I started working out again. And so everything was going along nicely, and then I got intermittent fibrillation.
Larry's a very active guy. He likes to work out in the gym, and it was very frustrating to him to have these intermittent bouts of palpitations.
Dr. Winter's an electrophysiologist in Tucson, Arizona, and very busy in his own practice. He doesn't do a lot of atrial fibrillation ablation procedures in Tucson and has sought out Dr. Natale to perform those particular procedures for him because of the number that Dr. Natale does.
There are certain procedures that are very difficult and that the local physicians don't have the training or the expertise to do. And atrial fibrillation, in my opinion, is one of those procedures. And Dr. Natale has been at the absolute starting of the procedure and continues to innovate and change.
One of the aspects of dealing with patient with rhythm problem is to make sure that there is a team approach. So we have put together a structure called Center for Arrhythmia and Atrial Fibrillation that include nurses, nurse practitioner, and the physician, and the secretary, that they are all work together, help the patient to go through the process of being educated about the rhythm disorder and all the treatment options.
Okay, so I just wanted to confirm with you, we have your appointments.
Dr. Winter called Dr. Natale's office and talked to Carla Walter, and Dr. Winter told me that I would be receiving the call the next day from Carla. I didn't think much of that, but sure enough, the next day, Carla calls me. And she was just so nice and so helpful. And so we started talking about potential days to come down and do an ablation with Dr. Natale.
We actually brought Larry in to visit with Dr. Natale on a Tuesday. He had his ablation procedure performed that following day on Wednesday. He was discharged from the hospital on Thursday morning and was back home in Tucson by the weekend.
Just like you said it would be. Wonderful.
Wonderful.
No problems at all.
Fortunately for me, I've never revisited atrial fibrillation.
He's like 20 years old again. I have never seen him so healthy. And we've been married 15 years. And he is energetic. He doesn't have any symptoms anymore. He feels like he's a teenager again.
I feel better than I did when I was in high school.